I have here an empty glass, standing directly on front blue and white paper. If I fill it with water, what do you think will happen to the colors? Will they remain the same or will they appear different? Let's check what you think. Who think that the color will remain the same? Who think that the color will appear different? Okay, most of you are right. Something will happen. But what? Let's try it. This is one example how I teach physics in my class. In this case, optics. I ask questions, I make the student think, predict, talk to each other and explain. I encourage and inspire curiosity, and they learn through demonstrating and activities. Many students think that learning physics is like climbing a cliff, hard, frustrating, and endless. Some of them stuck in the middle, and when they give up, they convert their potential energy to kinetic energy. Physics doesn't have to be scary or difficult. Physics doesn't have to be boring or tiring. I see physics like a huge amusement park. I enjoy physics. I love physics. I love to teach physics. So I want my student to feel the same vibe. We can teach physics in a variety of methods so the student will have deeper understanding and have fun while they are learning it. My name is Kobi, Kobi Shvarzbord, and I've been a physics teacher for the past 16 years. At my school, 25% of the students study physics. This is 300% higher from the national average. I have classes in which almost 50% are girls. This is because I believe that teaching physics should be exciting and fun. The focus on teaching and learning is on what is actually being taught, not on the student and not on the teacher. They are engaged in the activities. I always in contact with other teachers, sharing ideas about physics education. And school is not just my workplace. To be in class and to teach is my love, my fun, my challenge, my adventure, my inspiration. So I would like to invite you to take a peek in my classroom, to my amusement park, Physics Land. We will begin right now. Let's solve a problem just like I remember from learning physics. Given the initial velocity of a ball and the horizontal distance from the launching point, what is the height above the launching level that the ball will pass through its motion? We can draw the ball. Here is the initial velocity. We put the xy coordinate and we write an equation. The x component of the position is the initial velocity multiplied by cosinus theta multiplied by time. Wait a minute. I just said we can do it differently. My student gets the same task, but they are really do it. They calculate for different distances what height is that the ball will pass through in his motion, and they need to attach a small ring at that point. This is a team effort. They take it very seriously. After we finish attaching on the rings, we line the ball, cross our fingers. 8 rings, 1 ball. Will it pass through all of them? You've got to see it.
Newton.
The response of the student is amazing. See how excited students can become from physics. And they never forget to add selfie to our Facebook group. Is there any kids who don't like candies? What about gummy bears? Why not use gummy bears in physics, like making waves? My student built a simple wave machine from gummy bears. Yeah, you heard right, gummy bears. You've got to see it. I need 2 volunteers, please, to come and help me. Thank you. Thank you. Come, you hold this side, and you can hold this side. This is the difference I was looking for. This is an exciting activity, but at the same time, it's deal with the basic concept of mechanic waves and the common misconceptions that students have in this topic. They actually measure the speed of the wave and arrive to conclusion that it depends on the matter's properties only. They see the wave move, but the gummy bears stay at the same position. One of the main misconceptions that students have. Thank you to help for helping me. After we finished the activity, and to be honest, even during the experiment, they eat the gummy bears. So they realized that physics can be also tasty and sweet. And I won't even talk about radioactive decay activity with M&Ms. As you see, food has a warm place in my class and in my heart. Just before we finish our journey, I want to take you far away. I want to take you to the particle accelerator at CERN, near the border of France and Switzerland, a visit to the cutting edge of physics research. After I participated in a high school teachers program at CERN for 3 weeks with teachers from all over the world, I brought particle physics into my classroom. My student built particle detector. They could actually see the interaction between particles from cosmic rays and the detector. They even play cards to understand the standard model, the basic building blocks of matter. This activity was created by a group of teachers from different countries. But most exciting, I take my student to visit CERN. There, they can see the largest and the most complex instrument that were ever built by humankind. At CERN, they actually can see how physics research is conducted, and they face the main question that physicists look for today. Why there are far more matter than antimatter in the universe? What is dark matter? What is beyond the standard model? Supersymmetry, maybe? They realize that we don't know everything and we don't understand everything. But most powerful for them, that they understand that perhaps they are the future scientists that may discover the answer for those questions. And if you can bring your student to CERN, bring CERN to your student. Set up a virtual visit or a video conference. I didn't start teaching like this. Only after I'd been a teacher for several years, I was looking to do something else. I wanted to do it different for my student. I want to do it more tangible, more exciting, more significant to them. I want them to learn better, to understand better, and have fun and enjoy themselves at the same time. I didn't create all these activities. I researched and had help. Teachers, you just need to want to find some good and excited activity. It's all out there. Search online. Reach out and share with other teachers. Become a member of a learning community of physics teacher. Have the courage to start and do it in class. At my class, physics is no longer difficult, scary, or boring. My students know that physics is all around us, even on my t-shirt. So you see, teaching physics differently is physically possible. Thank you.